Season 4, episode 1 doesn't have anyone speaking Russian, but there is a Russian song playing when Winona Ryder is opening the box with the Russian doll. So let's just look at this episode. Красная армия всех сильней. It is a real Russian song. I personally don't know it, but I'm sure I can find the words to this song. Russian people singing Russian song. It's real Russian language. The next clip where we see people speaking Russian is in the second episode of season 4 and at about 20th minute.
Ты куда собрался? Ты куда собрался?
А ты куда собрался? А собираться, собраться is to get ready. А ты куда собрался? Where do you think you're going? This actor has good accent. I'm not sure if he's English or Russian. I understood everything he said. And I just want to say that the point of this video is not to make fun of people speaking Russian. It's about having an example and use it as a case study. If I can give constructive feedback about why certain words sound different in the show and the way I would pronounce them, if I can actually break it down and say this vowel sounded wrong or this consonant could have been soft or hard, and then you can actually learn it as a skill and then apply it to your Russian pronunciation, and then this way you can actually enhance your Russian skills, your Russian pronunciation. So again, it's not about saying, oh, he said this wrong and that's why he's bad, or I'm simplifying it, but again, I'm not targeting somebody in the sense that he is like a bad actor or his pronunciation is funny. Is about using it as a case study and saying, hey, I think this would sound better if you make certain tweaks in your pronunciation. And of course you can hear that I have a harsh accent myself. I know how difficult it is to master pronunciation. I know how difficult it is to get rid of your native accent when you speak foreign language. The comment that I get sometimes, oh, your pronunciation is horrible. How is it supposed to be motivating? It's not constructive criticism. Constructive criticism would be if you actually can help somebody to be better, and that's what I'm gonna try to do. And I think it's also a safe environment because we are analyzing the TV show, we're analyzing actors, not like a real person or not a student and saying, oh, you pronounced it wrong, that's why you should do this, this and that. Having this kind of like screen between us and the person we are talking about, because it's an actor, it's still a character, it makes it even more safe for us to give feedback or criticize sometimes. So I think it's a great opportunity for everyone to learn Russian language and learn how to pronounce Russian. And I can already tell that all of the actors on the show did a phenomenal job learning Russian language, American actors and Russian actors learning English. And I think we'll have less problems with their vocabulary, more problems with their pronunciation. Again, languages are hard, accents are all different. That's why if I can be helpful and you can benefit from it, that's all this video is about. Next, we have a very brutal scene where they're hitting him and they speak English throughout the scene until the moment where they call
Тащите слона.
Тащите слона. Тащите слона is drag the elephant. When I was watching it, I didn't know if the elephant is a person, like a nickname, or if they're actually gonna bring an elephant, and I was surprised to find out that elephant is противогаз. So again, that's the nickname for противогаз, слон. The next clip where they're speaking Russian is at the 40th minute, where the guy is at the phone booth and he's talking and the Russian lady is interrupting him. So let's listen to the language of the Russian lady.
Мне позвонить нужно, сколько можно здесь стоять? Мне позвонить нужно, I need to make a call, I need to have a call. Сколько можно здесь стоять? How long are you gonna be standing here?
How long can you be standing here? Notice how in Russian language we use a lot of the passive form. So, for example, I want to call, I have to call. In English, in Russian, we would say мне нужно позвонить. The phrase мне нужно is very common, very used, very popular in Russian because it, again, something is needed to me. It's more polite in Russian to speak this way versus saying I want this, I need this. So, the call is needed to me. That's why I need to call. Да? Мне нужно позвонить. Мне нужно идти в магазин. Мне нужно купить продукты. For example, the child is saying, Mom, play with me. Can you play with me? And then you are saying, I need to go to the store. In Russian language, it actually makes more sense because you're saying that the store is the reason of the problem. The store is the reason why you need to go there because the store needs something from you. I need something from the store, but the store is the subject, not you. So, very common to have this like passive formulation in Russian language. Вам тут что, домашний телефон? What is it here? Home phone? Вам тут что? Домашний телефон? She's fine and she's Russian. And then a little bit later we have a scene where Hopper is laying on the floor and then the two guards or officers are talking to him. Let's see what they say.
Еще жив. Или дышит.
Еще жив. Still alive. Жив from the noun жизнь. Life from the verb жить, to live. Я живу, ты живешь, он живет. So he is alive, он жив. Но еле дышит. Дышать, to breathe. Но еле дышит. He's barely breathing.
Если так продолжать, он умрет.
Если так продолжать, он умрет. Если так продолжать, он умрет. If he continue, продолжать is to continue. If he continue such, this way, он умрет, he will die. Умирать, умереть, to die. I think the second guy is actually Russian. He speaks in this harsh accent. He speaks good English with this like harsh, obviously exaggerated Russian accent. But then his Russian is absolutely perfect, so... Отправьте его на Камчатку. Send him to Камчатка. Not sure why they chose Камчатка. Probably because it's close to America, or maybe because Siberia got so overused. So that's why they want to send him to Камчатка. I personally don't know if there are any like harsh prisons, but Камчатка is a beautiful island in Russia. I would compare it to Yellowstone. Has a lot of nature and natural, I would say, phenomenons like geysers and landscapes and wildlife. Why they sent him to Kamchatka? I don't know. Maybe there are prisons there. I think they're just making it up, just not to use Siberia. Великодушием ты никогда не отличался. Великодушием ты никогда не отличался. You were never known for your generosity. They translated it this way. Yeah, великодушие, generosity. Отличаться is to be different, to be excelling at something. Отличаться, like отлично, да, is five grade, A grade, отлично. Or in Russian we say five is отлично.
Видно, что ты никогда не был на Камчатке.
Видно, что ты никогда не был на Камчатке, доктор. Видно, что ты никогда не был на Камчатке, доктор. Видно, it seemed like ты никогда не был, you've never been на Камчатке. Это Камчатка. Доктор, both in Russian and in English, the same. We can say врач или доктор.
Человек не заслужил покойной смерти.
Этот человек не заслужил покойной смерти. This person did not deserve peaceful death. Этот человек не заслужил, did not deserve, покойной смерти. So the word покойной, very interesting, because we have a word спокойной, and you probably know it from спокойной ночи, good night, or have a quiet night, have a calm night. And покойный is actually so calm that you're dead. Покойник in Russian language is the dead person. So покойной ночи is like quiet dead night.
Вот я и отправил его в ад.
Вот я и отправил его. And that's why I sent him в ад, to hell. The next clip where they speak Russian is at 54th minute, where Hopper is at the prison, where Hopper arrived to Kamchatka.
Отныне вы больше не люди. Вы винтики. Винтики машины на службе нашей великой родине. А если с дури попытаетесь бежать, на вас устроят охоту. Вас поймают. И последнее, что вы сделаете, это познаете великие мучения по славу Родине. Второго шанса у вас не будет. Отныне вы больше не люди.
Отныне вы больше не люди. Отныне вы больше не люди. From now on, you are no longer men. Люди, men, people. Больше is more, longer. Отныне, I wouldn't use this word. There are many other substitutes, but from now on, отныне.
Вы винтики.
Вы винтики. You are cogs in a machine. Вы винтики.
Винтики машины на службе нашей великой родины.
Винтики машины на службе нашей великой родины. Cogs in a machine in service of our great motherland.
А если с дури попытаетесь бежать?
А если с дури попытаетесь сбежать? А если с дури попытаетесь сбежать? Дурь, from the word дурак, fool, дурь, foolishness. Бежать is like бегать, бежать, я бегаю, я бегу. Сбежать is perfective, да? To escape, бежать, to run, сбежать, to escape. А если с дури попытаетесь сбежать? And if you're foolishly try to escape, attempt to escape.
На вас устроят охоту.
На вас устроят охоту. На вас устроят охоту. You will be hunted down. Again, notice how the passive form again, not we will hunt you down. Мы будем охотиться на вас. So common in Russian language to use the passive form. На вас устроят охоту. On you the hunting will be organized.
Вас поймают.
Вас поймают, you'll be captured.
И последнее, что вы сделаете, это познаете великие мучения.
И последнее, что вы сделаете, это познаете великие мучения. И последнее, что вы сделаете, это познаете великие мучения.
Во славу Родине.
Во славу Родине.
Второго шанса у вас не будет.
Второго шанса у вас не будет. You will not have the second chance. Второго, like первый, второй, третий, второго шанса, chance у вас, you will not, you, не будет, not have. His Russian is so good and has perfect accent, so I'm convinced that he is a Russian actor versus American actor faking Russian accent. The next clip where they speak Russian is again Hopper is at the prison, he's walking and the men are shouting at him, so let's listen what they're gonna say. Выпустите меня, выпустите меня, set me free, let me out. Выпустить, let out, впустить, let in, меня, me. I think the last man said, ты здесь умрёшь, ты здесь умрёшь, you will die here. Again, умирать, умереть, to die. And then the clip where they're actually listening to the tape when the Russian woman was at the phone booth talking to the guy who's at the phone booth.
And she said "мусор", and actually in the Netflix show they translated it just like "I would мусор", literally means trash or garbage, but it's the way we call cops. Probably we call guards as well. Logically makes sense, policemen and guards to be called the same way. Мусор. I like how Winona Ryder says "мусор", 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 "мусор". So this was it for episode number 2 in season 4.
In episode 3, we hear Russian speech on the 23rd minute. Let's check it out.
Чё, американец?
Ты чё, американец? What's up, American? Чё, американец? Ты чё is the same as ты что. Чё is just more casual and also a little bit more rough, like more vulgar to say чё. So ты что, американец, would be better. Американец, American man. Американец, итальянец, китаец, японец. Американка, китаянка, японка. So ка for feminine. American woman.
Чё там копаешься?
Чё там копаешься? Why are you hustling? Why are you like doing something there? Копаешься is not to be ready. Копаешься. Or here they translated it as what is taking you so long?
Уставший что ли сегодня?
Уставший что ли сегодня? Уставший что ли сегодня? Уставший is to be tired. Как я устал. I'm tired. Уставший is just passive form. Что ли? Adds uncertainty. What with uncertainty? Сегодня, today. Are you tired today? Что ли? You will hear a lot of the ли, бы, ж. All of these little particles add uncertainty to our speech. So it's not saying that, oh, you are tired. It's more saying, are you tired? Are you?
Свинья.
Свинья. Пик.
Что ты сказал? Урод!
Урод! Here they translated it as asshole. I would say that's a good equivalent. And then the next guard comes and he says Antonov. And just from the one Antonov, I can tell that this actor is actually Russian. He said Antonov, just a very pure Russian accent. Antonov, he made the last consonant sound devoiced. So instead of saying Antonov, he said F. He put the correct stress. Не Антонов, Антонов. Антонов. So the stress is in the middle. Stress is a very big problem in Russian language because you never know where the stress is. So it's always all over the place. And unfortunately, for most of the cases, majority of the cases, you just have to learn where the stress is placed. And here he said it all correctly, of course. Антонов.
Антонов. Заканчивай с этим америкосом, он на рельсах.
Заканчивай с этим америкосом.
Заканчивай с этим америкосом.
Заканчивай is кончать, заканчивай to finish с этим, with this америкосом. Ну, it's a slang for американец, да, америкос. Он на рельсах нужен.
Он на рельсах нужен.
Он на рельсах нужен. We need him at the tracks, at the railroad.
Сейчас, сейчас, я просто хотел приструнить его.
Сейчас, сейчас, я просто хотел приструнить его. Сейчас, сейчас is now, now. They translated it as yes, yes, but it's actually now, now. Я просто, I just, просто is just, хотел, wanted, приструнить его. Приструнить, I'll tell you, it comes from the word струна, which is a string, a guitar string, for example. And then струна... Приструнить is a verb to put somebody in a place, да? Put somebody on their own place.
Давай.
Давай. Oh, we're gonna hear this word a lot. Давай, 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 давай means so many things. Давай is okay, fine, let's go, let's do it, we are ready, come on. Everything is давай.
Везде свой нос сует. God.
Везде свой нос сует. Netflix translated it as noisy bastard, which is a good equivalent, but it actually means везде, everywhere, свой нос, his own nose, сует. Сует is to shovel, to stick into.
So, везде свой нос сует. Put his nose everywhere. The next clip is at the 34th minute where he is asking the other prisoner about the favor that he wants to trade his meal, his bread, for him actually hitting his chains. Let's see how the actor who's playing Hopper is speaking this part and how the other actor is speaking and if you think that the other actor is Russian or American. Шевелитесь, твари! Шевелитесь, твари! Remember, they use this word a lot. Шевелитесь is to move, but шевелиться is more like, you know, barely moving, trying to move. Like you would say, шевелиться about the leaves on the tree, moving a little bit. Шевелиться, like if somebody is very small, is trying to move. So шевелиться is to move, to stay alive, do some action. Шевелиться.
Один человек, один кусок, что непонятного?
Один человек, один кусок, что непонятного? Один человек, один кусок, что непонятного? Понимать, understand, я понимаю, I understand, непонятного, what's not understandable about it?
Я сказал по одному куску на человека.
По одному куску на человека, one piece per person.
Я не петух.
Okay, this phrase не я не петух. Netflix translated it I'm no fairy. I don't know how much it gathers from it, but петух, a literal translation is rooster. In prison jargon, in prison language, петух means taking advantage of sleeping with men. With other prisoners, so петух is basically the prisoner who sleeps with other men, with other prisoners.
Нет, нет.
Нет, нет. Hopper says it very softly, and of course he's not trying to fake that he knows Russian, so he's doing a good job, because I understand what he says, and at the same time he says it completely wrong. So instead of saying a very pronounced U, because it's a vowel on its own, he sort of exhales and says just the letter T with an exhale. Listen how he said it. T, 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 T. The way you would pronounce it as T, T. So you have this U, U sound. If you struggle with pronouncing E and U differently, again, just think about U being pronounced with your lower jaw moving forward and kind of having the square mouth configuration. U, U. And also, I've heard people explain it as like if you've been punched in the stomach, kind of like U. If you can find this sound once, you will be able to replicate it. So just try to find it. Don't be shy. U. Разбить. The second word he says разбить. Also, he says it very softly, very low, so it's hard to hear, but разбить is to break through. Можно разбить посуду, to break dishes, да, разбить его оковы, его chains.
Я там паю.
And then this part I had to listen a few times. I couldn't understand what he's trying to say. I would assume he's saying я дам and then the word bread, я дам хлеб. But he's actually saying я дам паёк, я дам паёк. Паёк is the portioned food. Usually паёк is something that military people will have or prisoners will have or any sort of like government officials that would give you like a packaged meal at a паёк. So I think he is saying я дам паёк. I will give you my food, my packaged food, my portion.
Я ж тебе ноги сломаю.
Я ж тебе ноги сломаю. Я ж тебе ноги сломаю. Я, I, тебе, to you, ноги, legs, сломаю, break. I will break your legs. And notice again how he added that particle, ж, about uncertainty. He's like, I will break your legs, that's for sure. You sure you want to do it? Je just adds that uncertainty, but doesn't have any additional, like, vocabulary. Я дам паёк. So now I can hear паёк clearly. Я дам паёк. I will give you my packaged meal.
И суп тоже.
И суп тоже. И суп тоже. And soup also.
Бешеный американец.
Бешеный американец. Netflix translated it as crazy American. Бешеный is the word that we use for sick animals. Usually the sickness, I'm not sure if I'll find the exact illness, but this is the illness that stray dogs have, or wolves, or sick foxes. So бешеный, I would say it like crazy sick. Crazy sick American, бешеный американец. The next clip where they speak Russian is at the 45th minute. Пошли, пошли. Пошли is the past tense of go. So, for example, you would use it more in a sentence like они пошли домой, they went home. But пошли can also be used in the imperative sense in the present tense. So instead of saying пойдем, let's go, or иди, you go, да, ты иди. He's saying пошли, пошли. Вы, plural, вы, you guys, пошли. Живей, живей, again, same word, он жив, жить, to live, живей, живей, is like keep moving, stay alive. Следующий, next.
Следующий.
Живей дети твари! Again, he's insulting them. This is it. This is all the Russian they speak in episode 3. So let's move to episode 4. In episode 4, we have Russian language on the 12th minute. Шевелись, скотина. We've already heard шевелись before. So again, that's moving. Скотина. Insult. That's how we would call farm animals, domesticated animals, скотина. Следующий, next. Next Russian language clip is going to start at the 27th minute. From what he was saying, I just understood. Я тебя спрашиваю. I am asking you. Я тебя спрашиваю. Again, пошел скотина. You go, and then a скотина is how we call the domesticated animals.
Чокнутый американец.
Чокнутый американец. Okay, чокнутый is also one of the words to say crazy. Чокнутый американец. It's not offensive. Чокнутый. Назад, назад, назад is go back, stay back. He said сломалось, сломалось, his wooden hammer. He's saying that the hammer broke. He should have said сломался, because hammer is молоток and it's masculine, but he's saying сломалось, like something feminine broke.
Не работает. Не работает.
Стой там!
He's saying не работать, or maybe he said не работает. Would make more sense to say не работает. Не работает. It doesn't work would be conjugated to the third person. So не работает or не работать is he's saying doesn't work. The guard keep telling him стой там, stay there, stay in your place, стой там. Then when he went to this little closet house, the second guard is asking
американец!
Где американец? Again, we remember американец is American. Где? Where? So he's saying, где американец? Where is the American? Работай давай.
Куда-то собрался, американец?
Ты куда-то собрался, американец? Ты, you, куда-то, somewhere, собрался, getting ready, you remember, собраться, собираться, американец.
Встать!
Встать! Встать is perfective, вставать imperfective. For example, you can say, сегодня я встал или я встала в 8 утра. Versus, я встаю каждый день в 8 утра. That's a whole difference. So, встать, he's telling him, right here, right now, perfective. Встать, stand up.
Быстро встать!
Быстро встать. You remember? Быстро, быстро, quickly, fast.
Руки! Руки!
Руки. Hands. Рука. Руки.
Сука!
Сука! Откройте! Откройте! Открыть. Open. Закрыть. Close. Бежать или бежим, to run, бежать, to run, бежим, we run.
Туда, туда.
Туда, go there. Туда is when we express direction, go there. Тут, here, там, there. Туда, go there, сюда, go here. I just want to mention obsession with peanut butter in American culture. There was, at the time that they are trying to say this show was filmed in Russia, because the phones are old, right? The phone booth, the paid phones, and then also the way they show prison, and the cars are also old. It would have been in like the 80s. However, in the 80s, I mean, peanut butter? I've never tasted peanut butter until I came to the United States. And even now, peanut butter is not popular and not loved, and nobody would actually carry it in the house. So it's just such an American thing to show that he finally got a hold of the peanut butter jar. Быстрее, давай! Faster, quicker, go, давай, come on, let's go.
Антонов! Антонов, тебя к телефону!
Антонов! Антонов, тебя к телефону! Антонов, тебя к телефону! You're being called to the phone, к телефону.
Что еще? Не видишь, у нас беглец? Говорят, срочно!
Что еще? What else? Ты понимаешь, у нас беглец? Do you realize we have somebody who escaped, беглец? Somebody who is бегает, бежит, somebody who ran away? And then the guy replied, это срочно, говорят, срочно. Срочно means urgently, срочно.
Welcome. Stand as a medal.
I think he said, Волков, встань на задание. Встань, again, stand up. Задание, assignment. Задание, упражнение. These are both words for assignment or exercise.
Hello.
Энцо, это Юрий.
Энцо, это Юрий. Энцо, this is Юрий.
Что такое? Ты зачем сюда звонишь?
Что такое? What is it? Что такое? Да, что это такое? What is it? Что такое? Ты зачем сюда звонишь? Ты, you, зачем, why, сюда, here, звонишь, calling.
Ты что, сдурел?
Ты что, сдурел? Again, you hear the word сдурел, дуреть. Do you remember? Дурак is fool. Дурь, foolishness. Сдурел, like went mad, gone, fool.
Я знаю, извини.
Я знаю, извини. Я знаю, I know, извини. Sorry, excuse me.
Просто я должен тебе сообщить, что у нас немного... План изменился.
Просто, just, должен, I need to, тебе сообщить, to you, сообщить, to send a message, to let you know. Я просто должен тебе сообщить, что у нас, that we, у нас изменились планы. Plans changed. Again, see how he uses a lot of the passive forms, not I changed plan, я изменил планы, but у нас изменились планы. Планы is the main subject, and they are affecting us. Да, у нас изменились планы.
А что случилось?
Что случилось? Что случилось? What happened? Я только что говорил по телефону. I just now spoke on the phone.
Своему начальнику.
Своему начальнику. Начальник is your boss, your manager. Начальник. So, своему начальнику. To my own manager, to my own boss.
Это полезная была беседа.
Это полезная была беседа. This was a полезная, something that's helpful, useful, productive, беседа, conversation, and Netflix translated it as very productive call.
Оказывается, беглецы больших денег стоят.
Оказывается, беглецы больших денег стоят. Оказывается, it happens to be, or it turned out, беглецы, again, the runners, the escapers, больших денег стоят, cost big money. Быстро.
Вот Юрий думает, а почему бы не оставить себе 40 тысяч? Еще деньжат подзаработать.
И вот Юрий думает, and now Yuri is thinking, а почему бы себе, not for myself, why not for myself, оставить, to leave, 40 тысяч, 40,000. Еще, again, one more, еще деньжат. Деньжат – это diminutive for деньги, money. Деньжат – подзаработать. Работать – to work. Заработать – to earn. Подзаработать – to earn a little. Да, подзаработать – just a little.
У нас совсем не такой был уговор.
У нас совсем не такой уговор был. We had not such agreement at all. We had a different agreement.
А Юрию такой уговор больше подходит.
А Юрию такой уговор больше подходит. Listen how this actor says this phrase, and listen how I say it.
А Юрию такой уговор больше подходит.
А Юрию такой уговор больше подходит. I think he's saying больше with a instead of putting a stress on o. Больше подходит.
А знаешь ли,
что стоит больше? Беглого зэка.
Продажные надзиратели.
А знаешь ли, again, here that ли for uncertainty, do you know, do you actually know? Знаешь ли, что стоит дороже беглого зэка? Зэк is how in Russia we call prisoners, зэк. А больше всего, and most of all, больше всего стоят cost. Американцы. You remember? Американец один, американцы много. Больше всего, good phrase to remember, больше всего я люблю мороженое. More than anything, I like ice cream. Больше всего я люблю компьютеры. More than anything, I like computers. Больше всего, more than anything.
Продажные надзиратели.
Продажные надзиратели. Это продать is to sell. Продажный is somebody who is being sold or corrupt. Надзиратель, these are the guards. Надзиратель. Ах ты гад. Netflix translated it as what have you done, but ах ты гад, ах is just oh, and then ты гад is like you bastard. Стой на месте. Стой, imperative from стоять, to stand, на месте. Место is place, so стой на месте. Stay on your place, on place. С дороги. Дорога is road or route or way. С дороги means get out of my way. From my way, from my road, from my route.
А больше всего стоят? Американцы.
А больше всего, and most of all, больше всего стоят, cost, американцы. You remember? Американец один, американцы много. Больше всего, good phrase to remember, больше всего я люблю мороженое. More than anything, I like ice cream. Больше всего я люблю компьютеры. More than anything, I like computers. Больше всего, more than anything.
Те, которых разыскивает КГБ.
тех, которых разыскивает КГБ. This is how he pronounced it. He pronounced it more like КГБ.
Тех, которых разыскивает КГБ.
But we make it sound all the same, so you would actually say it КГБ. Разыскивать, искать, same word, искать, to search, разыскивать is when police do their searches. Розыск, разыскивать.
Прощай, Энза.
Прощай, Энза. Прощай is a formal way of saying goodbye. Да? We can say до свидания is until next day. Прощай, we would say when we are not going to see this person at all or not see it, him, her for the long time. Прощай is like a permanent, semi-permanent goodbye. Прощай.